In this section, we will see redundant circuit. Redundant means it is like an extra circuit setup. What happens if you are using redundant circuit? Here in this diagram, you can observe that R3 is a redundant circuit. If you remove this R3, no, then also there is no effect in this circuit operation. Here now you can observe that across this R3, they have short connected this circuit, R3, they have short connected here. No current flow through R3, so it is short connected. So because of this current flow from this battery to R1, R1 to R2, R2 to this short circuit back again to this battery. So because of this R3 is a redundant here. And also the short circuit make a lower resistance path. Always current flow in a lower resistance path. So it will flow like this. And also you can observe that the same operation in this second circuit diagram also. Here now, from point A to point B, it is short circuited through a wire. Point A and point B, this is short circuited through a wire. So the current which is moving from this battery supply to R2 to from A to B, it will select this short circuit path and it will not select R3 and R4 path because it offers some resistance for the flowing of current. Always current select a lower resistance path. So here you can observe that no current through R3 and R4. So it is a redundant circuit. Branch AB is a redundant. So this is the one type of redundant. We will see another type here. In this another type, no? This point and this point, these two are not connected at all. Obviously, if these two are not connected, means there is no flow of current from this B to C. There is no flow of current. So this portion of the circuit, it is of no use at all. So this is a redundant branch. Here you can see what they have written here. If there is an open circuit. Here this is an open circuit. In the branch or combination, it cannot carry any current and become redundant. So obviously this is an open circuit and it will not carry any current at all. So it becomes a redundant circuit. So here we have seen there are two types of redundant circuits. This is first case and this is second case. Next we will go with the Kirchhoff's law. These are all basics and you already know about this one. But while analyzing this circuit behavior, no, we should use KCL as well as KVL laws. We'll revise that concept once again so that we can apply this to circuit. How we can apply this to circuit, we can see that. So first one is KCL. We'll see what is that KCL explains you. This is the KCL. Here you can observe that KCL operation in this circuit. Here you can observe that incoming current at this junction is equal to outgoing current. Incoming current is what? I1 and I2. These two are incoming at a junction O. I3 and I4, these two are outgoing at the junction O. So because of this you can say that I1 plus I2 equal to I3 plus I4. So incoming current is equal to outgoing current. So here you can say that what they have written, the total current flowing toward a junction point, total current which is flowing I1 plus I2 to a junction point, which is a junction point O, is equal to total current flowing away from that junction point. What is that total current? I3 plus I4. So here in this section they have told that I1 plus I2 equal to I3 plus I4. So incoming current is equal to outgoing current. Sum of incoming current is equal to sum of outgoing current. Here they have written algebraic sum of all the current meeting at the junction point is always zero. Obviously here the current which is coming toward this junction, you can consider this one with a positive sign. And current which is moving away from this junction, you can consider that one with a negative sign. So you can represent I1 plus I2 minus I3 minus 4. This is equal to 0. So they told all the junction point current summation I. Summation I means I1 plus I2 minus I3 minus I4. This is equal to 0. So for the representation purpose, the current which is coming toward a node, you can represent this one with a positive sign. The current which is moving away from this node, you can represent this one with a negative sign. So here the current flowing toward a junction point are assumed to be positive sign. The current flowing away from the junction is assumed to be negative sign. I1 plus I2 equal to I3 plus I4. Next we can have Kirchhoff voltage law. So what this Kirchhoff voltage law tells? Around a closed path, it always applicable to closed path, summation I, summation V equal to 0. What is the meaning of this? Algebraic sum of all the branch voltage around any closed path or a closed loop is always 0. This is the algebraic sum. This summation represents, this is the algebraic sum of all the branch voltage and all the closed path is always 0. In any network, algebraic sum of voltage drop across the circuit element of any closed path or loop or mesh is equal to algebraic sum of EMF in the path. We will see that what it will explain. And also you can see that sign convention which is applicable which we can use while analyzing any of the network element and all, any of the network analysis will use the sign convention. We'll see when it is used and all. And you should always remember that always current flow from higher potential toward lower potential. In this first diagram you can see that potential of point B is higher than potential of point A. So current is moving from B to A. B to A. Here you can see that the potential of A is higher than potential of B. So current is moving from point A to point B. Next, with respect to KVL, Kirchhoff voltage law, we will apply that once to this closed loop. Here I have the power supply, resistance R1 is there, R2 is there, R3 is there, and R4 is also present. While you are analyzing this, while you are tracing this, you know that current is moving in this fashion. Because you have the power supply, from power supply it is moving like this and it will come back. So obviously current is moving from left side to the right side of R1, right? If it is moving from left to right, you can represent this one by positive sign and you can represent this one by negative sign. Because current always moves from higher potential toward lower potential. So you should represent this one with a positive sign, you should represent this one with a negative sign. And also for R2 you can observe that this is of positive sign and this is of negative sign. Because current moves from higher potential toward lower potential. For R3 also you can represent like this, plus minus. Current moves from right side toward left side, from higher potential toward low. For R4 also this is plus and this is minus. Move from bottom toward top side. Here in this diagram, in this second diagram, it is clear. For R1 plus and minus, for R2 also plus and minus, for R3 also plus and minus. So we will apply KVL for this one and we will see how that equations looks. So here you can observe that here you have E1, E2. These two are the power energy source. And also, if you start to trace from this one, no? If you start to trace from point node A, we'll see. If you start to trace from node A, you are starting to trace from node A. Whenever current is moving from higher potential to a lower potential, you can represent this one by a negative sign. Minus I1 R1. Next, for battery, no? This E1 energy supply, it is of opposite sign. So you can represent this one by plus E1. Similarly, that current flow like this. And also here it is moving from higher potential to a lower potential. So you can represent this one minus I1 R2. Why it is minus I1? Because current is moving from higher potential to a lower. Similarly, it moves like this next. Minus I3 R3. Next, minus I4 R4. After this, you can see that now it will E2 will be of opposite direction, right? Minus and plus. If you compare R4 with R3, R4 sign is plus here and it is here minus. For E2, no, it is minus and it is obviously here E2 is in opposite direction, right? So you can represent this one with plus E2. So that is represented by this expression minus I1 R1. Plus E1 minus I2 R2 minus I3 R3 minus I4 R4 plus E2 equal to 0. If you can rearrange this one, how can write down this? E1 plus E2 equal to E1 plus E2 equal to. If you take all the terms to RHS side, it becomes I1 R1 plus I2 R2 plus I3 R3 plus I4 R4. So, according to definition of KVL, no? Sum of voltage drop across all the elements is equal to algebraic sum of all this voltage equal to EMF you have connected. This makes that KVL. So, here they have arranged that expression. E1 plus E2 equal to I1 R1 plus I2 R2 plus I3 R3 plus I4 R4. While applying KVL, direction in which a loop is to be traced important, but follow sign convention is the most important. Steps to apply Kirchhoff's law to get network equation. What are the steps we have followed in previous circuit diagram? No? That same steps we will apply here. KVL must be applied to sufficient number of loops. How many loops are there now? For all these loops, you should apply KVL such that each element of the network is included at least once in any of the equation. You should not skip any of the network element while you are applying KVL for this network loop. Next, we will see how we can apply this concept to this. So, what happens if it is having current source? Here you can have, no? If you are having voltage source like this, no? We have seen how we can apply for this. Effect of current source is already considered in terms of current distribution. And also, if you are having current source, 5 amps, this is a current source. This loop cannot be considered for applying KVL. We should skip this one. If it is of current loop, if it is of having any current source, you should consider that it is like a open circuit. Here you can observe that. Here in this loop, whatever the current that is flowing, you know, you can consider that current as I1. this current. Here you can observe, no? I1 is flowing like this. Next, remaining current. What is that current? You can consider I minus I1. Remaining current. That is the remaining current that is flowing through this point B to C. So we have considered. What is this I? I is nothing but your current source. Current source current is I. Phi. Phi minus I1. That is flowing through point B and C. So we have considered that. So because of this, while applying KVL for this circuit element which is having this current source of 5 amps, you have to neglect this. You should consider this is of open circuit. Then you can apply KVL for this section. So we will see what they have written. If there is current source in the network, then complete current distribution considering current source. Complete the current distribution considering current source. But while applying KVL, loop should not be considered. Here in previous circuit diagram, no, what we have seen, no? There we have not considered the loop which should not consider involving the current source. If it is don't having any current source, no, we should not involve that. Loop equation must be written to those loop which do not include any current source. If it don't have any current source, then only you should write loop equation. This is because drop across current source is unknown, because we don't know how much voltage drop will take place there. If we know, then if you know the voltage drop, then only you can write down the expression. If you don't know, means we should not use that. So because of this, here you can see A, B, E, F, A. For this should not be used for KVL equation. We are not using this one for KVL equation. Only you are using this section for the KVL. Its effect is already considered at the time of current distribution. This loop having current source 5 amps, we will consider this one at the time of current distribution. So we need to apply KVL only for B, C, D, E, B. Only for this one we need to apply KVL. For this section we need no need to apply KVL. So here now we have considered one simple problem. There we can see how this KVL is applied. These are all basic concepts we are discussing here. What is that problem? Apply KVL, current law and voltage law to the circuit. Indicate various branch current. Write down the equation relating to various branch current. Solve these equations to find the value of these currents. Is the sign of any of the calculated current negative? If yes, explain the significance of negative sign. This is the problem where we need to apply Kirchhoff's law for this circuit element. First, for this circuit element, first we will represent all the network element with a plus and minus sign along with the current direction moment. Here now, here you have one power supply 50 volt, another power supply 100 volt. Only in one direction we will consider current moment. This is clockwise direction I will consider. Or you can consider anti-clockwise direction. In only one direction you have to consider that. Fine. Here now, current which is moving from node A to B, you can consider that current as I1. And current which is moving from B to F, B to E, you can consider this current as I2. Because I1 is not equal to I2, because as this I1 is moving from A to B, no? Some portion of I1 is flow through B and C branch and remaining portion flow through B and E branch. So because of this, across this branch B and C, which current is flowing? I1 minus I2. How much current that is flowed, no? I1 minus I2, you have to make remaining current that will flow through this one. That same current also flow through this. By considering current in a clockwise direction, you have to represent sign convention for all the network element. Here, if you are applying sign convention here, no, it is plus minus, and also here, this is a plus minus, and also for this plus minus, it is flowing like this. So we will apply that KVL law for this one, and we will see how we can write down this. For loop 1, you can write down, for loop 1, minus 15 I1 minus 20 I2 plus 50, this is equal to 0. For loop 1, which is your loop 1? ABEFA. This is your first loop, ABEFA. For this one, if I apply KVL for this, which current is flowing through 15 ohm resistance? I1 is flowing. So, minus I1, 15. Why I should consider minus? Because current is moving from higher potential to a lower potential. So you can represent this one as minus 15 I1. Next, I2. So another current that is flowing is I2. I2 is flowing through 20 ohm resistance minus I2. But for 50, you can observe that actually when you are moving in a clockwise direction, plus minus, but it is of minus plus, it is in reverse direction, right? So you can represent this one as a plus 50 volt. So you can see that expression here, minus 20 plus 50 volt, this is equal to 0. Similarly, for another loop, you can write down the expression. What is that? For another loop, you can write down 30 into minus I1 I2, and also here this is of same direction, right? What direction that current is flowing for this 30 ohm resistance, no? In that same direction you have connected this 100 volt. So because of this 100 volt also being some minus 100, and for this one, but this 20 is of minus to plus, it is moving from lower potential toward high. So you should represent this one with a plus. Plus I2 20 ohm, this is equal to 0. You can look at this expression. I2 50, this is a 50 ohm resistance, right? 50 ohm resistance. They have done some mistake here, instead of this one, no, they have considered that. So let it be. We'll just see the procedure, what they will follow here. They got these two expressions here, we'll see. Okay. They have not done any mistake here. Actually this, by after simplifying this expression, actually whatever the tracing equations we got, now we got that. After this one, if you simplify this one, you will get this one. If you want to find out the current I1 and I2, you can apply Cramer's rule. In M1, you have studied about Cramer's rule while solving the variables, while getting the result of variable I1 and I2. In determinant form, you have to write down 15, 20. Here, 15, 20, 15, 20. Minus 30, 50, minus 30, 50. Next, for D1 means you have to remove this first column. First column means should be removed by this 50 and 100, 50 and solve this determinant, you will get found. If you want to find out I1, D1 divided by D, you will get this. For D2, you will get for D2, 50, 100, solve this one, you will get D2 by D. You will get I2, you will get this expression. You will get the value for I1 and I2. if you want to find out the current which is moving through that common branch, no, you can find out I1 minus I2, that is nothing but minus 1.85. So a negative sign indicates assumed direction is wrong. Actually it is moving in a opposite direction. So you got the sign of negative. This is the procedure. How we can apply KVL equation for this network analysis. In next section, we'll go with some other concepts. I hope today video section is clear for you all. In next section, we'll go with next some other more concepts. Actually, all this KVL law application and all, these are the basic concepts, but we have revised this concept. We had done the revision for this concept so that while solving the problem, we should not get any doubt regarding this. Thank you.